the backdrop. In terms of NASDAQ's participation, though, it is a completely unregulated space today. It's at a height of a hype cycle, and there's just a lot of different players out there. What we are seeing, which I think is quite encouraging, is that a lot of exchanges are really trying to become more self-regulated, mm-hmm. make it so that they have fair market rules, they have a great technology, they have good surveillance of their activity, and that's the first thing that we've started to do. We mm-hmm. are the technology provider to a few of the crypto exchanges, and we continue to see an opportunity for us to provide our surveillance technology and our market technology to those exchanges.
One of those partners is the Winklevoss, right?
That's right.
So mm-hmm. what is that, the nature of that partnership?
Yeah, so that particularly is that they really want to make sure that they create a robust surveillance program to make sure that they're rooting out any sort of manipulative behavior in their markets. And we provide that technology that allows them to do that. So mm-hmm. it's really a technology partnership. We also provide the trading and clearing technology to another exchange, and we continue to find opportunities for us as a tech provider to enable the markets that exist. As NASDAQ as a market, we've been investigating the futures, and we continue to have, I think, a robust dialogue with our clients on that. But we didn't necessarily think being a first mover was necessary. We want to make sure that we offer a future instrument that where you can rely on the price formation and the availability of pricing of the underlying exchanges. And then the second thing is that, you know, over time, does this become more regulated? Does it become something that's more mainstream? Then, you know, then we would look at what should NASDAQ's role be.
Right. So the other overarching thing that I just kind of want to bring back to here is the role of blockchain in all this, mm-hmm. right? So how do you plan for the growth of that, which it could be still so far away?
So the self-regulation part is very, very important for this market to recover. And if we're going to hit that $1 trillion, $2 trillion market cap, obviously we do need the government to pass some common regulation and allow institutional money to come in. But there's also got to be some sort of self-regulation against market manipulation. And it's good to see that NASDAQ is getting involved with other exchanges and helping address this issue, because we do not want more and more. I mean, Mt. Gox is a perfect example of just not regulating security, because that's one part. But the other part, too, is spoofing. I'm sure you guys have heard about that. But a lot of this problem will go away as markets become larger and larger. And it's a lot harder to manipulate the top 10 coins. And that's why I kind of invest in the top 10 instead of going to coins that might have below a billion market cap, because then you do have to worry about more issues when it comes to unfair trade tactics. So it's just really important that you pay attention to that stuff and that you educate yourself. And it's awesome that NASDAQ is getting involved with blockchain and helping exchanges like Gemini and the Winklevoss brothers keep it as a robust market, like she mentioned. But let me know your thoughts about this, and I will talk to you guys soon.